So welcome guys, in this video I will try to cover the forward part of the ship, including the marking, the waterline and all other things. And in the further videos I will try to cover the midship section and thereafter the aftward section. Right, this is a 3D model of a Mary Merckx. It's a Tripoli class ship. The length overall is 399.2 to be precise, and the breadth of the ship is 59 meter, and the draft of the ship is 16 meter. So I will let you know how we calculate, how we measure the length overall, and the length between perpendiculars, and then the breadth of the molded breadth and all other things. Right, so let's get started with the video. As you can see, this is the forward section of the ship. This is called the bulbous bow. Okay, this is called the bulbous bow of the ship. Okay, these marking, or I hope that you are able to see it, these markings are called the draft markings. Okay, these two holes are called the bow thrusters. It's not necessary that every ship will have a bow thruster. Okay, bow thruster are given to for ease of maneuver. Okay, this indicates that there is a bulbous bow over here. Every ship don't have a bulbous bow. The ice class ship don't have a bulbous bow. Okay, they have it, but that is extra strengthened. Okay, these two indicate that there is a stern thruster over here. Okay, this is the name of the ship, Mary Merckx. Okay, these are the fair leads. Okay, through which the mooring line are passed over to the pier or over to the tugboats for assistance. Okay, in this model the anchor is not shown over here, but assume this plus sign as a anchor, and the pipe through which, or the empty space through which the anchor is coming out, is called the hawse pipe. Okay, I will cover it when I will cover this forecastle deck. So the gap through which it is coming is called the hawse pipe. Okay, assume this ship right ahead, then this part is the port side of that ship and this is the starboard side. Okay, so now this is the forecastle deck of the Mary Merckx. Okay, so this direction is called the starboard bow direction. Okay, starboard bow. I hope that you are able to see my cursor. This direction is called the starboard bow, and this direction is called the port bow. Okay, this is called the port bow. Right, so guys, now we are in the forward most part of the ship. This is called the forecastle deck, where all the mooring and anchoring work are done. Okay, and these are the fair leads through which the mooring rope is passed to the pier or the jetty or to the tugboat for assistance. Okay, so these are the mooring winches over which the mooring ropes are held. These are the warping drums. You can see there are several mooring winches over here. These are the mooring winches. These are the warping drums. Okay, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 6 mooring winches are there, and along with a warping drum is there. These are called the bits. If you can see, let me zoom it. These are called the bits. Okay. These are called the bits. Okay, there are several bits over here. You can see these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is called the deadman roller. Okay, deadman roller, because the head can roll. Okay, this is basically used to change the direction of the mooring rope. So if you want to pass this mooring rope from this lead, you will pass with the help of this. It will change the direction also, and it will not create a friction which will harm the rope. Okay, so now these are the brakes. These are the, let me zoom it over here. These are the mooring winches. Okay, this is a warping drum. These are the mooring winches, and you can see a brake. This is the brake lever. Okay, this is the brake lever. So now we will have a look on the anchoring part of thing. Okay, the pipe through which this chain is going, which is attached to the anchor, is called the hawse pipe. Okay, it's called the hawse pipe. Okay, this is called the windlass. This is called a windlass. This whole setup is called a windlass. The roller over which the anchor chain is passing is called the gypsy. Okay, it's called the gypsy. These are the anchor chains. These are the anchor chains. Okay, and the pipe through which it is coming out from the chain locker. The pipe through which this chain is coming out from the chain locker is called a spurlin pipe. Okay, there is a chain locker beneath these. Okay, which holds this chain. So just have a look of windlass. So this is a riding power over which there is a chain stopper. Okay. So guys, this is the forward mast of the ship. Okay. This is the forward mast of the ship, and it has all the navigation lights. You can see it. It has the navigation lights. So guys, I hope that you like the video. Until then, see you. Bye-bye.